Coming to you from Hollywood, California, where McDonald's sells the McRib year-round, it's the Josh Macuga Show. Tonight's guest from Collider TV Talk, David Griffin. And now your host, a guy who tore his hamstring and quad doing the same dance move at a wedding, it's Josh Macuga.
All right, everybody, welcome back to the Josh Macuga Show. I'm Josh Macuga, your host. I guess that makes sense. I'm here. Before we get into it, you guys can follow me on Twitter and Instagram, at Josh Macuga. Subscribe to the channel here. Here's the thing. Let's just say you're driving on a cross-country road trip and you have an RV, and you have the chance to cover your RV in like what they call a skin. You could cover it in the Josh Macuga Show channel, subscribe to it on YouTube, and you could drive across country. You stop at a gas station, there's like a guy that may or may not be shady. He could be like the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. You're like, oh, what's the Josh Macuga Show? You tell them all about it, and they can tell the people that he's kidnapped and locked in his basement all about the show, and they can watch it on a laptop that they share. Yes, it's creepy, but hey, we're going there. Tonight, my guest has been trying to get him on the show for a while. You guys have been asking for me to get him on here, whether it's on TV Talk, whether it's on this channel, whether it's on a mailbag, a movie talk, on Twitter, on Facebook, Instagram, wherever. Why hasn't David Griffin been on the Josh Macuga Show? Well, the answer is right here. David Griffin.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. I was not sure what to expect. That Josh Macuga Show. This is a real deal. This is a real show.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
Well, kind of an insult.
No. I know you're capable of it.
Took a shot.
I know you're capable of it.
Yeah, you took a shot. I see what it is. I see. It's a real thing. You do the whole thing. when we first started doing TV Talk, the first time we met was auditioning to be the hosts of TV Fights at Screen Junkies.
You know, when I found out the results of that, I was in Scotland with my dad on a golf trip.
Whoa.
That's when I found out. I got a note from, I don't know, it was Andy, one of the guys over at Screen Junkies, saying that we know we're going with somebody else, and I got back and I found out that Roxy got it.
I got a voicemail from one Ken Knapsack while stuck in traffic. So you were golfing in Scotland, I was somewhere on the 101. Regardless, neither one of us got that job, but we did get the TV Talk job.
Yep.
And we've become really good buddies since.
Yeah, it's almost a year. I think like in April or May, it's going to be a year. It's crazy.
It's crazy, right?
Yeah.
I will say the highlight of my week is Mondays because we spend from, and I know that a lot of people ask, when is it going to go twice a week? I think what eventually we'll do is daily.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people, but we watch and text about TV all week long. And then we finally get to talk about it on Monday. Mm-hmm. And people are like, why do you guys talk so fast? Well, because we have like 70 shows to really talk about, and we just yell about it for an hour, and then you're exhausted. I mean, are you? I'm exhausted.
I don't think anybody understands how much TV we actually watch. I know when I was doing Iron Fist, plus we had 5 Amazon pilots. That's in a 2-day period. That's 18 hours of television in 2 days.
Yeah.
Plus I have another job, plus writing, plus Collider. So it's like you have to do all that, then go on camera for an hour and talk really fast in detail about every little thing.
There's a reason.
It's like, you got to remember all those details from Iron Fist, which was not great.
It wasn't great.
No.
And there's a reason that you're single, and there's a reason why my fiance hasn't watched TV in upwards of 4 months, because she just passes out watching shows that I'm watching.
But at least Amanda is on the couch with us. She's present with you.
Yeah.
I'm all alone.
Present is an operative word. Is present looking at Instagram while ignoring you? Is that present?
You have a body near you.
Yeah,
you have someone near. Yes, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm, yeah. And you'll hear a giggle, and I think she's watching the show, but she just watching a meme on Instagram. So
those are funny.
Yeah.
I may have done a little bit of that watching Iron Fist as well.
Because I know we briefly mentioned on a couple shows, but you weren't gonna do what you're doing now.
Yeah.
You were in seminary.
Yeah, I was in seminary. I came out here specifically for seminary. I have my master's in theology. I had 4 years.
You have a master's in theology?
Yeah, master's in theology. I took ancient Greek, ancient Hebrew. They wanted us basically read the Old Testament and the New Testament in its original language, be able to translate to get the context.
Can you speak Greek and Hebrew?
No, I can read some of it. I can't speak it though.
Wait, what?
I'm not fluent or anything
okay,
like that.
Got it.
Many people are fluent in ancient Hebrew.
Yeah, I was going to say.
But no, I wanted to be a pastor. So every time I come in, like, oh, Dave, like, what do you do on the side? Like, are you like an actor? Are you trying to be like a producer or writer? I'm like, no, I was going to be a pastor. I was supposed to be in church. My roommate, Liam, is an ordained minister in the Baptist church. Now he's a wine salesman.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's just kind of how that works.
I'm an ordained minister at ordainyourself.com. It's an online church. Dude,
crack jobs, there's so many people that have that. I don't even have that. And I was in seminary for 4 years. I couldn't marry you and Amanda. And I could basically get one step away from being a pastor, and I can't marry you. I'm sorry, buddy. I need to get one of those little certificates you guys have.
Yeah, I have a card. Hold on. Is my wallet still back here? Nope.
I have a degree, but I can't marry you.
You can't marry me. I've always, like, wondered, because you come from a really great family. I have yet to meet your mom and dad. I can't wait till I come out to L.A. to meet them. But were you, like, a real spiritual dude growing up?
No, man. I was in joined a fraternity in college, first semester, freshman year. Got right into fraternity life. Yeah, I was watching the show with Amanda. I think she said you were basically a lifetime frat boy. Mm-hmm. That's going to happen. Yeah. So, I mean, even if you weren't, you had that persona.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I miss that. That's why I love being around you, because it reminds me of being in college. You're a good guy, Josh. But no, my parents know, my dad's a doctor. My mom's a family counselor. And there's nobody in our family that's a pastor.
The Buffalo, New York version.
Buffalo, New York version of the Huxtables. Yeah, every school I went to, like, your family's kind of like the Huxtables. I was like, yeah, they kind of, my mom's light skin, so yeah, we kind of look at the Huxtables a little bit.
And your sister's an opera singer.
She's an opera singer. She lives in New York City.
And you could have been a seminary.
I could have been.
Seminary? That's an opera.
Seminarian.
Woo. Man, yeah, my that's Catholic all right.
No, the terminology's weird. Yeah, the
terminology's
weird.
You're terrible.
Yeah, I could have been a pastor.
But you were going to be a pastor in what? Like, in just in like a Christian church?
Non-denominational. I could have gone Baptist, anything. I wasn't in the Catholic seminary, so I could have gotten married.
Gotcha.
But yeah.
And so then, what was the transition then?
About halfway through, 2 years through my 4-year program, I just said I wasn't happy.
Wow.
And I loved websites like IGN and Collider and all these like entertainment geek, you know, video game websites. And I said, well, people have full-time jobs. And how do they get full-time jobs? So I found Think Hero, which is Dennis Zen, who's now the head of one of the heads over at Collider Video. Mm-hmm. And I Facebook stalked him and said, I want to get into this business. Roth was still over there, Kristen Nettlepeck, who started the Geeky Awards. And I said, how do I get into this? He said, send me a writing sample. So I think X-Men First Class had just come out. So I wrote a 3-page review on X-Men First Class. And he told me to come meet with him in his condo in Hollywood, and just down the road, actually. And I met with him, and the rest is history. I met Roth.
Usually when somebody says, come meet me in my condo in Hollywood, on the internet,
I'm a pretty good sized guy. I can handle myself, so I'm not really too worried. Dennis looked like a little kind of innocent looking Asian dude. You know, who knows? Maybe he knows some moves, but I was like, what's he going to do? But so that's how it all started. I met Roth that very night. And kind of took off from there. Now Roth is over at, you know, Screen Junkies, IGN. Sure. So I've been fortunate to meet the right people when I needed to.
Did you always have like a passion for TV?
I was a creative writing major in undergrad and a history major, I did two majors. So I love writing and research. I read a lot. I read books. I actually do. Our whole thing at the end, Josh says, you know, put down the book and pick up the remote. I'm actually reading a lot. I actually am reading and watching the TV. So
interesting.
I like to read a lot as well. Yeah.
Dang. Yeah, so you're the kid that my parents wanted to have as a son.
You are a great son, Josh.
I'm the dude sitting here.
You're a great. You're a great guy. Your parents, yeah. I've never met your parents. I met your aunt and uncle.
Not my aunt and uncle. You're gonna meet my mom in a couple weeks.
Oh, good. So, okay. Go. Nice.
But yeah. Oh man, you're basically, when you talk about going into seminary, when I was a kid, my mom and dad would get in fights. My dad would come out and be like, just be a priest, boys. Just be a priest. And he'd walk in, and I'm like, okay, well, I mean, we could do that, or we could just, like, not do that. I'm like, you know what I mean? And then you go to seminary, and my dad would have flipped out. If I'd gone to seminary, and my dad would be like, oh, my dreams are coming true, and my son's going to be a priest. And then 2 years in, and they'd be like, all right, Macuga, you had sex with, like, 2 Italian girls in the same week, and we saw you leave a bar. And I'm like, whoa! What do you want with it?
But see, that's the thing. Whenever I say I went to seminary, everybody kind of like tightens up. Yeah. They're all like, oh, sorry, I swore. Oh, sorry. Like, oh, like, you know, like, oh, you're conservative. You know,
fucking
like,
they just
assume
Griffin.
All these things. And it's not really the case. I'm a pretty open guy.
Got it.
I'm trying not to judge or preach or anything like that.
Let's go into tonight's game. Tonight's game is called I Need a Hero. How I Need a Hero works is I have a cigar box I got for being the best man at my buddy's wedding, and I ran out of cigars about a year ago.
Beautiful box, though.
Yeah, it's lovely. It even says my name on it. there are fake superheroes that I've invented in here, and you have to pick one and then tell me who they are, what their superpower is, what like their backstory is. I mean, you're a writer. You were in the seminary. Write like a backstory for one of these superheroes.
It prepares you to classify superheroes.
Yeah, it does. There's a seminary class you call called Superhero Mythology of the Old Testament. Okay.
I don't want them to be named David.
Don't look.
Okay, did I take it or you take it?
Take it.
Okay.
What do you got?
All right, we got a guy, Mousehead Human Body Guy.
Mousehead Human Body Guy.
Mousehead Human Body Guy.
Now, he was struggling on what to name himself, so he just said Mousehead.
So is he, so this is like a human.
Yeah, but he's got a mouse head.
He's got a mouse head, but he's got a human body guy.
Yeah.
So he doesn't have anything else. He doesn't have the cape or anything. I picture him in his whitey tighties.
Well, here's the thing.
With a mouse head.
Yes, correct.
No cape.
Oh, okay, no cape.
So he's part homeless.
Sure.
So he's a homeless guy who has enough money to maintain the mouse head, and he goes off and fights crime at night in the areas where the homeless are, because homeless are getting attacked in L.A. That's a serious problem.
Yeah, agreed.
Homeless get attacked, you know, innocent homeless people, and he defends the homeless people. This guy is a man for the people, the homeless people.
And because there's so many rats around, they're like, oh, that's just a guy that
has... Yeah, he just blends in. And they're like, a lot of them are on drugs and schizophrenic, so, I mean, they just assume that he's just another rat mouse running around.
Mouse head rat.
He just blends in. No one knows it's him. So it's like some big mouse came and saved me last night. I'd watch that movie.
Genius.
Sold.
This summer on Hulu. All right. Pick me another one.
Okay. Captain Fedora.
Ooh, that's Paul. That's Paul's favorite superhero. Paul loves
this guy probably lives in like Echo Park or Silver Lake or something like that. Yeah. No. So when we were on vacation with my dad in Florida, he's been seeing like the hipster thing. He's seen the news and talked about the hipsters, and he sees the fedoras. He wants a fedora.
Oh, no.
I think he wishes he was a hipster. You know, he's getting almost 70 years old, so he wants to relate a little more. So he was hoping to be a hipster.
Your dad, my dad.
So I think my dad could be Captain Fedora.
Oh.
You know, because he's a doctor, so he's saving people.
Oh.
You know, but he wears a fedora in the operating room.
Whoa.
Do you ever see Clooney wear a fedora in the operating room?
I never did, not on ER.
Well, Dr. Griffin's going to do that. That's your show right there.
Dr. Griffin is Captain Fedora. This fall on NBC. Well,
on TV, I mean, medical shows are huge. So, I mean, you figure,
it'll be in that Chicago shared universe.
Yeah.
But a Chicago doctor leaves for Buffalo and puts on a fedora, and all of a sudden, Captain Fedora. When the hipsters in the neighborhood don't think he's qualified.
That fedora is, it's serious.
They over-vaped. They, like, they vaped so hard that they, like, passed out. Captain Fedora comes in and is like, I got you. They ate too many, like, vegan.
But, like you can't do it right unless he puts a fedora on.
No.
Like, if it's a fedora, he's like, oh, no, what do I do?
Oh, God, fedora.
Yeah. What if, like, the knowledge came from the fedora?
Whoa, that's pretty
good. You know what I mean? Like, he's not really a doctor without the fedora.
Yeah. Like, lightning struck a hospital, but he was wearing his fedora as he was walking out.
Yeah, like the Flash, like Barry.
Yeah, exactly.
Instead of speed, he has super doctor knowledge.
Super doctor knowledge, but only with the fedora.
Only with the fedora.
He's walking around normally, just like, bah, 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 bah. Fedora, he's like, it's 50 cc's of stuff.
Do you concur?
Yeah.
Do you concur?
I concur,
I concur, exactly.
Doctor. All right.
So we have a superhero called the Common Cold.
Ooh.
That's not a superhero. I don't he could be a superhero that helps people get over the common cold.
Oh.
Like he shows up at your door, you know, hopefully not too creepy.
No.
You know, gives the kids some medicine, maybe, you know, some Robitussin, you know, maybe some cough medicine, and just kind of goes away.
Kind of sounds like a NyQuil delivery service.
A little bit, but you know, but maybe they're called the Common Cold, the Common Cold Delivery Agency.
Is that like those topless maids vans? But
with not with the little kids. That's a little creepy. Unless it's maybe they have like a subsidiary
but adults
of
get
that.
Common Cold too.
That's true. Male adults, they want the topless maids. They could get that. So that's an option. That's extra. You pay extra for that. Hmm. But superheroes don't really get paid, so you gotta do it for free.
Yeah,
that kind of defeats the purpose. That's a tough one. The common cold's tough.
Man, what if it was Common the rapper and he was like Cole? All right, let's pick another one.
That's a tough one. That one's tough. Okay. The human birthday cake.
Ooh, birds!
This
yes.
is the person that walks around all the time just surprising everybody.
Ooh.
With happy birthday. Every day is somebody's birthday. And he comes in with real life candles.
Ooh.
So he wears a cape. A costume that's a cake, and he has candles. You have to light them. And you just blow them out. You make a wish. Everywhere he goes, make a wish.
And his wishes, do the wishes come true?
Always.
So, but they get one wish.
You get one wish.
So is his whole body?
But it's only if it's
like
on your birthday.
A cake.
Yeah, and he's like the Kool-Aid man. He just busts down that door, break down that door, and say, "Oh yeah!" lit with candles.
But candles. So he's a cake.
He's a cake with candles. You blow them out, and you make a wish. But there's always consequences with the wishes.
Oh no! Yeah. Like what?
I don't know. It's just never what you think it's gonna be. You know, it is a wish. You get his wish. There's always some, you know, thing attached to it. There's always something attached to it.
Yeah, it's like marriage.
Yeah. Oh. I'm not touching that one.
Good drink pause.
Yeah, as a single man, I don't know anything about that.
Let's do one more. Here you go.
All right, here we go. Cruise ship bartender man.
Yeah.
See, when I think of that, I think of you, Josh Macuga.
Yeah.
I can see if Josh wasn't doing what he was doing now, I could see him as a cruise ship bartender, just making those old ladies feel special.
Hey,
that's
Helen,
all it is.
You're looking good.
Yeah, I mean, that's all it is. It's just, you're just a regular, this is a regular dude. You don't need superpowers to be the cruise ship bartender man.
Oh, I know.
The old ladies see, like, that's a cruise ship bartender man.
Yeah.
That's Josh Macuga.
Yeah.
Not that you can do more with your life. I'm just saying, like,
what if the cocktails I made, like my special cocktail power was, I made cocktails that like made old women feel young again.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Cocoon almost.
Or you could, oh yeah. So you have like a certain elixir.
Ooh.
You can make people fall in love. So you know, yeah. It's young people. You're like, give me that special drink, but you charge extra, make a little on the side.
Nice.
Yeah.
Like a love potion.
A love potion.
Nine.
Yeah. But if something goes wrong, the cruise ship is in trouble.
He always wears a vest.
And maybe like terrorists attack the cruise ship. If you make an elixir, like, hey, give me a drink, man. You make him a drink and it makes him fall asleep. And then save the day there.
Cruise ship bartender,
show.
Man.
Yeah, we're making some good shows here. Good
we
television.
Are.
This is good television. I would watch these shows.
This is the Greg Berlanti CW universe.
We're pitching ideas here.
I need a hero, David Griffin. We'll be right back after this commercial break. Hey there. The Surgeon General recommends that when you leave the house, you bring your keys, your wallet, and of course, your Magic Hat beer. It's for drinking and curing most diseases, along with public anxiety, and when girls don't like you. Magic Hat beer. It's perfect. Do I drink it? Should I drink it now? We're back here with David Griffin. He is the king of the seminary. He's my co-host on Collider TV Talk. You can see us every Monday. Hopefully, it's going to be every Monday through Friday. You know your television, but what you don't know right now is what is going on in the dating scene here with
I'm
David
looking
Griffin.
For love, man. I'm just you're trying looking, to find some connection, man.
Too many, I feel like you could be a really good bachelor. You're like the guy. Listen, you're not like bearded hunk McGee over here. You're not like like stuff and dudes and chicks, like, you should be the bachelor. That's when you sounded gay. You're the real bachelor. I would love to see a network take a risk.
An everyman bachelor.
Not like that, like a guy that girls and a girl. It's like a real natural kind of dating thing that would actually happen. Or just like a documentary about the life and times of David Griffin on the dating scene in L.A. Because it's been rough of late, huh?
We're talking to some of your friends out here. It sounds like everybody's struggling out here.
Yeah.
It's tough in L.A. I'm on Match.com paying my $30 a month looking for love, looking for a connection, and getting nothing back. If I pay $11 a month for Netflix, I at least get a movie.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, when I go on Match, might not get anything. Just don't know.
So yeah. You're on Match right now.
I'm on Match.com. That's the nice one. That's the one you pay for.
Yeah.
You know, that's
what about eHarmony? Is that just for old
eHarmony's people? That's even more intense. That's like, that's if you're looking for like Christian love.
Oh.
Spiritual love. You go there. Match is a little more diversity.
So let's start on the gamut. So it starts at Tinder. Right.
Tinder's low, yeah, like, it's free.
Ashley Madison, or
actually, that's like for affairs. You gotta be in a relationship to go on Ashley Madison. I'm not even in one yet.
Right.
Yeah. So let's. Or maybe just looking to have an affair.
So there's high slut. We'll start at high.
Yeah.
Slut.
there's like old women, like MILF stuff going on there. That's a little too much for me.
Adult friend finder. Then Tinder.
Then Bumble.
Then Coffee Meets Bagel.
Yeah, then like Plenty of Fish. Okay, Cupid is free.
Farmers Only.
Seminary Dropout. No, there's Christian Mingle or something.
Christian Mingle. Don't even tell them that you're not in the seminary.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, dude, you would destroy on Christian.
But then
we
go on the first date and be like, you're not like still pursuing your Christian goals. Like, not really. I'm just talking about like Game of Thrones and stuff.
Yeah. Don't just listen. Let like the third date go by and then tell them what's up, because then they'll be in love with you. They're like, I love this David Griffin. He's like sort of a Christian pastor. I haven't been to his, I say pasture?
I'm out to pasture. I feel like I'm out to pasture.
No, come on.
So
Do you want a wife and kids?
I was told by a girl today that the drive was too much, and she just, she wants to try it out with another guy that she's dating right now. So that was a match. I went on two 3-hour dates, meaningful dates, kiss from the last one. We just kissed on Friday night.
Whoa.
I texted her again. I said, love to see you again. She's like, you know, David, the drive, which I understand, you know, love dies at the gas
Where's
tank here
from?
In L.A.
San Francisco?
Redondo.
Oh, that's a long way.
That's a little long way. And she said, I want to try it out with this other guy, see how that works out. Mm. Which is not her. Hey, she was honest. She got back to me in a timely manner. Some people just don't text you back.
Yeah,
at least she texted me. She told me what was going on. So I had to credit her for that. But there's a lot of options out here, man. There's 12 million people in L.A. County.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people out here that we know of that are registered.
Could be aliens.
Yeah, it could be aliens. Yeah, you never know. No, it's tough out here, man. It's tough.
I want you to find a lady. I know my lady wants you to find a lady. She thinks you're just fantastic.
I would love to. I'm trying, man. I'm trying to be a courteous. I hold the door open. I pay for the dinner. You know, I don't send like dick pics and stuff like that.
6 months and she's still here.
Well, from what I heard from your video with Amanda and your first couple dates, man, you're doing it wrong. Ooh, all wrong. Brutal. I do it right. Yeah. No luck. Maybe I should start doing it wrong.
Doing it wrong.
Just show up wasted.
Yeah.
Just like bring like, hey, got a 6-pack of beer and some sandwiches. And yeah. Just like, oh, he's so nice. Yeah. He's so great. Yeah, I need to do that.
See?
Yeah.
Maybe it's the less you care, the more they love you. Babe?
See, I can't.
Nope,
yeah,
she
no,
see,
she's, nope, she doesn't like that. Doesn't no, man, it's not into that one. It's tough out there, man. It's
I think
a struggle.
We need like an Amanda cam on this show. For
well, it's tough at Collider, too, because everybody that we know, everybody's in a relationship.
I know.
Campia, Dennis, everybody's got some girl. You.
Well, Campia's married.
Campia's married.
Dennis has a girl that comes
Sinead's around. Sinead's something. She's doing all right. Sinead's got a girl.
Sinead's got a guy.
Or, sorry, guy. Sorry, not a girl. Sorry, why I said that. She has a guy.
Christian's married.
Mark has a girlfriend.
Yeah, Mark has a girlfriend. Ken has a
computer. Copster's taken. I can't, yeah. Got no luck with Copster,
But don't compare yourself to the people around you.
I know. It's hard not to, though, man. I know it's not a good place to go because you should just be yourself and focus on you.
What are you looking for in a lady? That's what I want to know. Because then I can start.
I don't think it's too specific. I like the girl I was seeing now. She was super smart. You know, she's fun. She's a physician's assistant. So she's really intelligent, pretty. Just a connection. Just have a good conversation, man. I'm not looking for anything. I'm not like that specific. Like just be a certain skin color or a certain size necessarily. I'm pretty flexible.
Really?
I don't consider myself too picky.
Man, I want to.
I'm trying though, Josh. I'm on Match. I'm paying my $30 a month. I'm talking to people. I'm trying
like
to communicate.
You're like West Side Rentals, basically.
Yeah, I mean, I'm available. I'm open. You know, this has got 2-bedroom right here.
Can we flash
nice
a number? Can we flash your number under here? Like, we need a
you can if you want to give it
100,
out.
No, get the
don't
Griff.
Do that. That'd be bad.
This is your first season watching The Bachelor, and I appreciate you watching that for me.
Yeah, it's fine.
Next season, TV Talks version of The Bachelor. We fly some girls out, we do some reality testing, and we actually have you compete.
That would
girls
be awesome.
Compete.
That'd be fun. I'd do that. I would
watch
do that for
the sponsors come pouring in.
Oh, we'll,
especially
okay.
Sponsors
we'll go 5
like
days a week real quick then.
Magic Hat. Sponsoring the best guy in LA that has yet to find it on Match.com. Hey, Match.com, thanks for spending $30 for fucking nothing.
Yeah, there's like this like 6-month deal. It's like guaranteed to find love. In
how
six
many months are you at?
2.
Okay, well, you're close.
So, yeah, 2. So I can't ask for my money back quite
not
yet. Yeah, it's not yet. I can't ask for money back yet.
All right, I'm sorry about what I said about you, Match. You seem like good people. All right. Hey, Match.com, new sponsor of the show. When eHarmony fucking blows, go to Match. All right, let's go into the deep end. This is, some of those questions. If you don't want to answer the question, you can pass.
Oh, no.
But if you pass, you have to
My
leave.
Mom might watch this.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Griffin. Oh, yes!
First question!
Yes!
Are you
most
serious?
Memorable sex I have!
The first question.
Do you want to answer this or do you want your mom to never see this?
No, she knows I've done it before. She asked me, I think, when I was like 16 or 17. She came to me, she's like, David, have you ever had sex before? And I looked at her, I said, yeah. And her face, I've never seen so much shock in her.
No.
I was probably like 18 or 19. I think I was in college, like a freshman in college.
Yeah, is that when you lost your virginity?
Yeah, but I didn't want to lie to her. I love my mom. We talk about everything. I don't want to lie, but she looked so shocked. Like
no,
the shock
I still
in her.
Lie.
She didn't like, yeah.
I've never had sex before.
Yeah, no, she knows. Ooh.
Deb
most
Macuga
memorable. I'm trying to think in my head. Probably my first. I haven't forgotten that. It wasn't like it was good. I just remember it.
Interesting. How'd it go? Candles, little Sade.
Well,
you open the door.
Well, I'm old. They can't ground me anymore. I was on my parents' bed. So, they can't ground me anymore. I won't send this link to my mom. So, yeah.
I'm sending it to your mom.
No, I was 16 or 17. I was like a junior in high school.
Holy
and parents
Lord.
Went out of town. And I had my girlfriend over. I was ready. She had.
What's
she,
ready
she,
mean?
Just as ready as a 16 to 17 year old boy can be.
Yeah.
She wasn't
couldn't
a virgin. She wasn't a virgin. And yeah,
she
we,
wasn't. But
she
you,
wasn't.
Okay, got
but
it.
But right. See, this is the thing. I gotta know my dad. My dad told me this when I was probably 11 or 12. This is the talk I had.
11 or 12?
Yeah. And my dad's like a doctor. And this is the talk. This is as scientific as he gets. He's like, David, he's like, it's gonna come a time when, you're gonna wanna have sexual relations with a woman. And he said, now, what you want to do is get a condom, get a hotel room. Do it the right way. And he patted me on the back and left the dinner table. That's all I got.
Do you know what my dad said to me?
No.
Drops me off at college, hands me a box of condoms, and he says, I'm going to give you 2 words of advice. There's nothing better than being drunk in the daytime, and if you come home with a grandchild, I'll kill you. So he gave me 50 condoms. I'd already lost my virginity, so it wasn't a big deal.
Yeah, so
yeah.
I mean, I did it the right way.
Our dads did two different things.
But I was safe. I heard my dad's voice in my head. I was safe. I had the condom, and it was harm was done.
And that was that.
That was that. It
what
wasn't
was
the
name?
Best. It was just I remember Haley.
Oh, Haley.
I remember her name. Yeah, I haven't forgotten her. Yeah. Still friends on Facebook. No, she has a family and kids now. Yeah.
Dang. What if you find a Haley out here? Let's find David Haley.
That's too much.
Haley's Comet, David Griffin, on his parents' bed. He's living the dream. You know who loved that? Cruise ship bartender man. He was a big fan of that. So was the human birthday cake.
Human birthday cake.
Here we go. Three for the road. Are you ready? Go. Do you take vitamins every day?
No.
How often do you wash your hair?
once a day when I shower. Hey, I wash it.
Soap
yeah.
up there. I'm pulling
my soap up there. Got to keep this clean.
You ever been blacked out drunk?
Yes.
Favorite SNL cast member?
Eddie Murphy.
Oh, okay. Do you have any nicknames?
D. Griff, G. Dog. Big G.
Who's calling you G. Dog?
When I was in, because I was the only black kid in my school, so they're like, "Hey, what up, G. Dog?"
Oh, this white people are the fucking worst.
All right. Hey, David, do you mind if people say the N word in rap songs? Like, how do you feel about that, bro? That's the questions I got in high school.
Yep. Yeah. Cool. Yeah. electric toothbrush or regular manual?
Electric.
Ice cream or frozen yogurt?
Ice cream.
Are DJs just people who are good at iTunes?
Yes. Nowadays, not in the past.
You ever had sex in public?
Yes.
You ever punched anyone in the face?
Yes.
What was your AOL screen name?
I think it's the same thing I have now. I think it's like Griffin DE, I want to say. I think it's changed in the last like 15 years.
When you had hair, did you ever have a perm?
I did.
That's amazing.
I used Relaxer.
Yeah,
it was
cool.
It wasn't like Soul Glow on
just to let your soul glow.
It wasn't that permy.
Are you a fan of strip clubs?
No.
Is your MySpace profile still active?
No.
Would you feel okay buck naked in public?
Depends where I was.
What famous person would play you in a biopic?
Denzel.
Yeah.
Look at how old he is. It's always Denzel. David, you're 32. Who do you want playing you? I want Denzel at 65. Denzel.
Would you rather Taylor Swift or Adele write you a breakup song?
Oh, Adele.
You ever won concert tickets from a radio station?
No.
On a scale from 1 to 10, how bad is your road rage?
5.
Most money you've ever spent on a bar tab?
200.
Did OJ do it?
Yes. That's a black man saying OJ did it.
That's a black man saying OJ did it. Can you play an instrument?
Yes, 2.
Which ones?
Saxophone and guitar.
Woo, minute left. Do you have an idea for an invention, but you just don't know how to make it?
No, yeah, I got nothing.
I got a bunch of them. Do you still call shotgun?
No.
Queso dip or guacamole?
Guacamole.
Do you have any Canadian friends?
Yes.
Favorite Olympic sport to watch?
Curling.
Ooh, that's a good one. You ever been kicked out of a bar?
No.
Ever been caught having sex by your parents? Well, you had sex on your parents' bed.
But they were out of town, so no, I was not caught until now.
30 seconds. Fish or chicken?
Fish.
Chicken or steak?
Steak.
Have you ever painted a picture?
Yes.
Bourbon or scotch?
Bourbon.
Beer or wine?
Beer.
Mozzarella sticks or jalapeno poppers?
Ooh, mozzarella sticks.
Favorite movie sequel? Bad Boys 2.
Do you ever take your vitamins? Godfather 2.
Oh, Godfather 2. Metallica or Guns N' Roses?
Guns N' Roses.
You ever been fired from a job?
No.
Do you own a gun?
No.
You ever tried dog food?
Yes.
You pee in the pool?
Yes.
You pee in the shower?
Yes.
NSYNC or Backstreet Boys?
I think it's in the sink. Backstreet Boys.
That's it! Yay! David Griffin! My man.
Thanks for having me. This is great. This is a real show.
It's a real show!
You got people and cameras and you got a backdrop.
And everything. We did it.
This is a real show.
The real show, brought to you by Magic Hat and David Griffin's Doubt and his Match.com profile. Ladies, you can find him Match.com/DGriff, a.k.a. G-Dog. Match.com. If you ladies are out there looking for a lovely young man with a sometimes full beard, sometimes shaven face, that grew up dreaming of being in the seminary.
Some people call it cemetery.
But is now just looking for love, go to match.com/gdog. You guys can find the David Griffin, the new season of Bachelor, coming to Collider in about 6 months. You're welcome. We'll see you next time on the Josh Macuga Show. Thanks for watching this episode of the Josh Macuga Show. We release episodes every other Wednesday, so subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Go to Facebook, I'm also there. Support our Patreon campaign. If you're watching the Josh Macuga Show, you're doing something right. And that something right is giving random people hugs when they don't want them.